Hi, I'm Rick with TGW.com, and this is the new Ping G430 LST driver. It's my intent to tell you who might want to try this driver, how it's going to help that player shoot lower scores. I got to hit this club for the first time. I'll go over my experiences, and I'll touch on some of the key technologies that go into this new driver from Ping. Listed are the standard specifications on this line of drivers from Ping. You can see there are two different loft models available in the LST, but remember that these are tunable in the hosel sleeve. Players can adjust the loft plus or minus a degree or plus or minus a degree and a half. And these drivers can be put into a flatter setting than standard, which is going to especially help players that tend to miss left. Ping is offering a bunch of no upcharge shafts and grips available for you. I got to hit this club with the Ping Tour 2.0 65 gram graphite shaft in the 9-degree loft with the Golf Pride Tour Velvet 360 grip. But remember, TGW.com will accommodate any of your custom requests. There are three different head models in the G430 line. There is the G430 Max, which is designed for the broadest range of players who are looking for maximum forgiveness and maximum distance on all types of shots. The SFT line, straight flight technology, is designed to help players reduce the big miss to the right. This one is the LST, which stands for low spin technology. It's designed to reduce backspin on your drives. It's designed for players typically with higher club head speeds or players that have a slight descending angle of attack into the ball with their driver and are looking to reduce the spin to give a more penetrating trajectory and maximize their distance. At address, the G430 LST looks very clean. It's a slightly smaller tour style head than the Max. You can notice at address, it's just not quite as deep from the face to the heel of the club. It's been reduced this way. It looks a little bit cleaner, but a traditional Ping look, you can see the addition of the carbon fly wrap on the top of the club. And Ping has done some work internally with some sound ribs to improve the feel and sound of the G430 over previous models. I was swinging this club just like the other two models at just over 100 miles an hour on average, 101, launching the 9-degree with a slight ascending blow at 14 degrees. I was getting a ball speed of just over 146 miles an hour on average, spin rate of 2100 RPM. So I did see a reduction in the standard setting of just over 200 RPMs from the Max model. With that, I had a lower trajectory of about 8 feet. My trajectory max height was 87 feet. I had a slightly shallower descent angle at 35 degrees and a similar carry distance of 252 yards. On average, my shots were only 2 yards left of center, so not only was this club very forgiving, but it was very straight. To start with technology, I would talk about the use of the optimized T9S Plus face. It is a shallower, thinner variable thickness face than previous models. It allows for more face flexing, provides a lot of forgiveness across the face, but especially higher ball speeds for more distance. And in this, the LST version, Ping is implementing their carbon fly technology to the crown. It is actually a carbon fiber crown that wraps around the toe, around the heel. It gives the engineers some discretionary weight, allows them to move that weight into more optimal locations inside the club to provide better trajectory, better launch conditions, and more ball speed. And new to the G430 line of drivers, which is something Ping's used on their fairway woods, is what they call spin consistency. And they've just literally changed the curvature to the vertical roll of the club. Shots hit low on the face typically tend to have too much spin. The ball will tend to rise and fall short premature. By reducing the spin rates on the bottom of the face, they're going to give more appropriate trajectories and better distance gains on shots hit compared to center strikes. And then there's the CG shifter on the back of the club. This is a 22 gram high density tungsten weight. It can be moved into one of three different ports. By moving this weight into the heel side of the club, you're going to promote a more draw bias club up to about 7 yards. And by moving it to the toe side of the club, you'll be doing the opposite, promoting a fade bias club. So if this club sounds like it might be a good fit for your game and you want to give it a shot, go ahead. TGW.com offers a 30-day mulligan buyback on any standard stock order and up to 90 days when you configure your custom order. maximum forgiveness in a low spin version that is giving players their biggest yardage gains to Ping's date. This is the Ping G430 LST driver. You can check it out. Check out our other product review videos all at TGW.com.